performing a nice little workout for you. We're going to start with 30 seconds of push-up.
Alright. One, go.
So we want to set a tempo at a level that we can control for the full duration. Robin's doing level one. She's holding a plank. You notice Robin's using the handles as well. She's got a bit of a wrist issue at the moment. She's keeping those wrists in neutral. You can use knuckles on the ground if you have to. She's holding a strong plank. Heels to head, long line. Rob's going for his knees. And he's pulling the floor to his chest, pushing the floor away. He's always going for the full position. Keeping that nice control, that beautiful tempo. Great stuff. Now we stand in the 30 seconds rest. It's an active recovery. It's staying loose. But it's really shaking the tension out of the shoulders, bouncing nice and light. You imagine that relaxed jump rope, that sort of action, but letting the shoulders go. You could have a recovery trot like so, but we do want to be nice and loose with this. Working on our breathing, that in through the nose, out through the mouth. Exercise two, left leg forward, split squat.
3, 2, 1, go.
Step it back. On those tram tracks, moving up and down. Notice Robin, he's working the top half. He's not even going part way down, coming back up. Rob at level two, he's going the full range, all the way down, all the way back up. All the way back up, still keeping the knee bent, okay? Don't push the leg straight. Toes is working that bottom half, really keeping this body. That's going to be burning. Good thing. Recovery trot again. 30 seconds of work with a strength type exercise, 30 seconds of active recovery. Keep working that breathing, guys. In through the nose, out through the mouth. Let the tension go. And in a second or so, it's going to be right leg forward, split squat. Right leg forward, guys. Feet on tram tracks. Back heel is nice and high. And we pull the head into those interlocked fingers. Pull the elbows back and make sure those bottom ribs stay down. Again. You don't have to get too caught up on this, but essentially trying to match the work you did with the left leg forward. So if we did 10 repetitions left leg forward, that'd be 10 on the right. If you're not counting, that's okay. Just keep the same tempo, same control. Front foot active, back heel high.
Stop.
Beautiful. Shake your legs again. Awesome stuff. Good, guys. That's the way. Nice and light. Working that recovery breathing, working the recovery, shaking loosely. Loosely good.
Halfway through your rest.
Now the next exercise is a bridge variation. Now we're going, I'm going to show you guys, we're going to go straight bridges. Robin's just going to show you a modification.
So
she's just going to do regular supine bridge for this first round. Just to show you that if you have any wrist, elbow or shoulder issues which don't allow you up into the straight bridge, because of the hand position, you'll stay here. And we're looking at a tabletop bridge, we're squeezing up like so. Tony's going straight bridge, he's adding another little twist to it. He's coming up on two legs, lowering for one. Squeezing up in two, lowering for one. Now Tony did the one leg there, I'm alternating legs, but next round maybe he changes to the other side, yeah? Now remember, ultimately we can be coming up and down on that one leg. But Tony knows where his glutes are at the moment. So keep the quality high, coming up on two, lowering for one. That eccentric, that lowering, we're always stronger in. So let's use that. We need to lower with control. All right, hold for exercise number five.
4, 3, 2, 1, go.
You kind of set up like a supine bridge. And then lift the heels, keep the toes just kissing the floor. Toes. That means the shoulders reach and the head stays between the shoulders. We're really engaging the tummy, keeping the back flat to the floor. Keep the legs still tall. So it's a hold this one, to hold. The rub is holding that position. The halfway point, you're going to change legs.
Recover for 30
seconds. A little bit more next time. Okay. Recovery trot. And then we're going to be into round two. Nice and light, working that breathing. Working that breathing through the nose, out through the mouth. a little bit more challenging, you could do the 1.5 repetitions all the way down, halfway up, back down, back up. Really good, that's the way. Now, yeah, of course, you don't have to do that, and to bridge that, maybe use that every other repetition. So we might do a full repetition now, all the way up. Next one, all the way down, halfway up, back down, back up. You understand how you can make this your own. Make yourself work hard, challenge yourself, make it so that you can maintain the work capacity throughout the whole 30 seconds. Four rounds in total, or up to four rounds. If you're pushed for time, maybe you do two or three rounds, but ideally you aim for four rounds. All right, so remember what we're trying to do here. Keep the back of your thigh. And as we move in and out of this, you might be feeling a stretch through your back hip flexor. I always like to set people up on those tram tracks from the knee directly over the ankle, back knee directly over the hip. Square pelvis, I come in, head through the ceiling with those elbows in position and push down. So I know I'm going to be in a good position now. Robin's going halfway down and up. Robin's going all the way up and down. Toby's going to the bottom half. Birdie birdie. Shake loose. Work that breathing. That was a recovery trot. It's a nice thing to do. Sink it into your feet. Feeling that floor. Slightly kissing the ground with the heels. Shaking the tension out of your shoulders. Keep the breathing under control. Right, the other leg. So, again, we want to keep this front foot nice and active. We want to keep the bottom ribs down. So I can get those pull those tummy muscles a little bit harder. Shrug the ball. At the same time, he's going to pull the bottom ribs down harder, but pull his head back, his head back into his hands stronger, pull the elbows back. You can see the back of his upper back, his shoulders working hard, the front of his upper body really opening up. Great stuff.
Recover for 30 seconds.
Shake loose, guys. They're doing a great job. Great job. That's the work. Staying loose. Trying to shake all that tension out. Recover your breathing. Get your mind right for the next exercise, which is a table. I'm sorry, it's a bridge series. So it could be supine bridge, tabletop bridge. Straight. Get ready, guys. Now, this time, Robin is going to go for it. She was just showing you the modification last time.
Two, one, go.
Robin's going two legs down. Really squeeze the butt and the hamstrings at the top again, keeping that tummy engaged. Tony's now looking low. You can choose what you do with this. He's coming up on two, lowering down on that one. He's working that right side this time. Awesome. Shake loose, guys. So while they're shaking loose, I'm just going to remind them this is the next one is a hold. It's not a dynamic exercise, we hold the position. So, level one is here, level two is here, we hold to halfway, we can see that. Level three is here, where we can scramble to make it a bit easier, or we can even shorten the position. We hold the position, so let's go, guys. Point those toes down, point those toes. That's open up, don't get any crunch ups. Mess, the mouse might be out of the house here, so. Don't make them laugh as well, instead of with the tongue. Nice, Rob, it's really good. Really good, guy. Think about it, we're really working this core. Trying to keep those. Think about pulling those ribs down like that, working those obliques. Avoid that flare going. Beautiful, shake those two rounds down. I can feel it. Oh, you are hot, Robin. You're not even hot.
Three, two, one,
I'm just going to show you again what a modification. robbing could do. So if you don't see knees robbing, if you wanted to start, if the plank is starting to get really doable, you have to move a little bit, because you can spend a little bit and back up. So we can work partial. But you know when Robin's doing these partials, still nothing's moving between the knee and the shoulder and the ear. She's not leading with her head, she's not collapsing, so she's only moving that little bit. Push straight into her hands and good stuff. Awesome. So she doesn't have to do that. That's something you can do to bridge that gap. Those little half steps, partial. Nice, guys. That really looks strong. Beautifully done. You're all strong. All right, those split squats. Almost round tracks. Back your high, front of the engaged. That's it. Back your shoulders a little more relaxed. Come on down. Exit. Squeeze them back. That's the way, without too much, just that right amount of sets, okay? Bottom rib down, so I'm trying to keep pulling that head into those hands. And Tony, like most of us, this day and age, 20th and 21st century living, got a little bit of falling head posture, so this drill is just so good to try and help correct that. We're trying to pull that head into those hands, we're trying to pull this back. But we know we've got to open this up a little bit more. We've got some separate work to do. Just another video that we've got coming up in November for. So. Beautiful, guys, beautiful. The other leg is coming next. The other leg is coming next, so again, try and match the work.
5, 4, 3,
pelvis square, bottom ribs down, nice long spine. So Robin's doing partials from the top, Rob's doing full range, Tony's doing the bottom half, really burning the legs. See how little Tony's really moving? But these legs are going to be working very hard. But the back leg is still getting a nice stretch. That hip flexor of his back leg is getting a nice stretch.
Stop. Recover for 30 seconds.
Now again, the benefit of doing these exercises with no equipment here, we're getting a full body workout. We're getting strength endurance, getting motor control, and we're getting some mobility work, obviously cardiovascular work. What we've just done with that split squat is trying to open this up after doing the push-ups. What we do with this exercise, with the split squats, we more, like I said, we stretch the back hip flexor. We've done both legs. So now, when we come to strengthen the back of the hip, these hips should open more. So we're getting the benefit of doing these exercises in this order is that, yes, we're developing more range of movement, more strength over the fuller range of movement, motor control over that. Brace up, guys. Shoulders together.
Stop. Recover for 30 seconds.
Very good. So say even just the floor is a stable friend, so we can open up these stiff areas, squeeze them, open it up, engage.
You are having a good show of rest.
Stretch it, strengthen it. Strong hands into the floor, pushing, crushing, corkscrewing, packing the shoulders away from the ears, back in the head between the shoulders. Pull the floor towards your chest. Push it away.
Halfway.
That's it. Working up the range now.
Position.
position, you're just getting a chance to still work on your recovery breathing while opening up that front of your body. So doing those hollow holds, a lot of tummy, some hip flexor. So if we can lengthen those out, that's great. And remember, setting the shoulders, trying to lift the chest. This shouldn't cause you pain. It's not normal for it to cause pain, but it's common. So if it does cause you pain, reduce the range of movement, so you could be taking your forehead to your hands. But it's a good position to practice the recovery breathing, the burst breathing. And when as Robin breathes in, her tummy's going to be pressing into the floor. But the same with the two guys as well. So it's kind of like, and as you start to, you learn that learn to breathe just using your diaphragm, you'll feel that breathing rate come down as you replace that oxygen debt. Once you've got a settled breath, maybe that would be a good time to do a little bit more stretching, some of the stretches that we've shown you, we'll show you further, but hey, you don't always have to do a big stretching session immediately post your workout. Think about 5 minute recovery here, go about your day and maybe do some stretching later on when you're on your floor at night watching the TV. Awesome work, guys. Great work. Give each other a high five and you're good to go.
Well done, guys.